a double strand of DNA unwinds and the strands separate. For each unwound strand, the bases can now match with those that are floating free in the cell. The familiar base pairing rules apply. A pairs with T, G with C, and so on. So each strand of the double helix acts as a template for the formation of a new complementary strand. This eventually gives two DNA double helices, each identical to the original and actually containing one old strand and one new. Mm-hmm.